Today is July 7, 2021. My name is Charles Suter. Today I'm presenting part three of my rationality series. This one titled Beliefs Become Destiny. My motivation for making this series available to you is to help you become a more rational person. My main message, your life reflects your beliefs. You live and achieve according to your beliefs. Most people don't connect their lack of success and happiness to the real cause, which are their irrational beliefs. Without knowing the cause of a problem, it's very difficult to fix it. Therefore, if you don't know how to correct any deficiencies in your life, you will continue to suffer from them. If you're suffering from an excess of emotional distress, or you are not moving progressively in the direction of your passions, dreams, and aspirations, then you need to focus on the real culprit, which is your irrational beliefs. The philosophy of rationality examines the logical consequences of human behavior, starting with a person's beliefs, which influences how a person interprets their reality, their subsequent self-talk, their ensuing emotions, and finally their physical actions. The real consequences caused by this chain reaction of human functioning ultimately determines one's success and happiness. And by success, I mean gaining positive, meaningful results from one's actions. And by happiness, I mean not suffering unnecessary emotional distress along the way. So if you are consistently getting positive results from your actions, then your causal beliefs are likely rational. If you aren't getting consistently good results, then your causal beliefs are likely negative and irrational. This presentation discusses the importance of getting, having, and keeping the right beliefs to avoid unnecessary emotional distress and as a means of achieving a high quality life. Proposition 1. Whatever your beliefs, they are controlling your destiny, and you may not even be aware of this. Your subconscious beliefs are the ultimate driver of your actions. Your actions define who you become and the quality of your life. Who you are now is a direct reflection of your current beliefs. Your motive for becoming a rational person is to live a life richer in success and happiness. Whatever your ambitions and aspirations for your life, the best way to achieve them is with a positive mental attitude based on rational beliefs that are opened to unlimited possibilities. If you're not actively working on or making progress towards whatever aspects of life you value, then you need to add more rationality to your life. Living a rational life is not difficult once you eliminate your most damaging and limiting irrational beliefs and replace them with their rational equivalent. Proposition 2. Most irrational beliefs are hidden within the subconscious mind. Irrational beliefs cause people to interpret reality incorrectly or improperly. Incorrect interpretations of reality lead to irrational self-talk. Irrational thoughts lead to emotional distress and harmful actions. The first requirement for becoming a rational person is to have a preponderance of rational beliefs, those beliefs that are accurate, supportive of your goals, and unbiased towards the negative. You will know if the preponderance of your subconscious beliefs are rational simply by looking at your life and asking if you're getting all the success and happiness you seek. However, if you have aspirations and passions that are unfulfilled, most likely, the cause is that you don't have the right beliefs. Most people live limited lives because their beliefs do not support their aspirations. Too many people hold themselves back from success that they seek due to self-limiting beliefs, such as this very prevalent irrational belief. I'm not good enough to get what I deserve or what I want. Have you ever had thoughts like this? To become a rational person, you must begin a campaign of finding and replacing all irrational beliefs as they become evident from the consequences of negativity stemming from your thoughts, emotions, and actions. Proposition 3. A rational person has rational beliefs. Rational beliefs permit an undistorted, unbiased interpretation of reality. Rational beliefs are also supportive of positive emotions. Rational beliefs are also supportive of positive, unrestricted actions. Most of your influential beliefs of how the world operates or should operate are hidden away in your subconscious mind. Your conscious mind may be aware of how it thinks the world operates, but is only partially aware of its subconscious irrational beliefs about how you believe the world should operate. Herein lies the problem. These shoulds are heavily laden with biases and incorrect assumptions and distortions. It's the irrational should beliefs that tend to get people into the most trouble. It's all your irrational and illogical beliefs that need to be found and corrected if you want to live a rational life. To change any pre-existing irrational beliefs towards rationality, you must strive to become aware of them when they surface during your self-talk, your emotions, and your actions. Any and all sources of negativity are evidence of irrational beliefs. Negativity is a good place to look for irrationality. You will know immediately when you have irrational beliefs because your thoughts will have a negative tone. You will suffer emotional distress, and your actions will likely be counterproductive, meaning you will end up getting more of what you don't want. My final message: your best future depends on developing a rational mind. Everyone is born with the seeds of greatness within them, but life experiences and their emotional and environmental influences ultimately instill upon the child their beliefs as they grow into adulthood. But as the adult, you're not stuck with the beliefs you grew up with. Beliefs can be changed and reformed towards a rational perspective through knowledge, motivation, and the will to change the future from its current trajectory towards one that's closer to your heart's desires. These presentations are intended to show you why it's important to free yourself from your irrationality and how to do so. The next presentation on thought control will begin the instruction on how to reprogram any irrational beliefs into its rational equivalent. That's all for now. Remember to stay positive. You'll be happier, healthier, and live longer.